Callan Lan is one of the great Welsh rugby hymns. It dates from the 1890s, but is as relevant today as it was back then. A rejection of gold and fine pearls, and a desire for a pure and honest heart. For the Great Britain Rugby Sevens team at the FISU World University Championships, though, the sentiment stops there. Sure, they dearly like the pure heart, but they also want gold. They start as defending champions. They won in France in 2012 and in Brazil 2 years ago. Now they're hosts in the Welsh city of Swansea, and they're here to make it three in a row.
I'd like to think so, yeah. Yeah, we've got a really well-rounded squad. We've got three of us, including myself, who've played before. Then the rest of the team are new to it, but all very competent players. So, bigger picture, we'd like to win it.
Sam Pointon is the captain of the British team, which is drawn from six universities: Bath, Loughborough, Cardiff Met, St Mary's, Exeter and Durham. He's one of three from Loughborough, which is renowned for its emphasis on sport. In spite of that, students aren't allowed to let their academic work suffer.
Being at Loughborough University, the university has a policy that academics always comes first, then sport comes second. Getting the match, it's just about time management. So say we're training, it can be up to 3 to 4 times a week, and we've got a heavy workload. The coaches always say the academic work comes first. But it's down to the personal, like individual, sorry, and just about your own time management.
One of three players in the 12-man squad to have won gold in Brazil 2 years ago, Pointon has rugby running through his veins. Not only did he go to rugby school, but his uncle Dave was a stalwart for Gloucester in the 70s and 80s. His dad, his cousins and brothers are also rugby addicts. The 22-year-old sports technology graduate, now studying for a master's in sports coaching, was a natural choice to lead the team in Swansea.
He played for us in Brazil. He's worked really hard at his game. He's worked hard at his sevens game. He's a quiet, unassuming captain, but we've decided to make him captain on the basis that for us, actions speak louder than words. When he speaks, he's listened to, he's respected by the guys. He's a very strong sweeper in defence.
His teammates are also more than happy to have the wise head of Pointon at the helm.
He's an awesome lad. He's a controller and he's a born leader, I think. So I think all the boys are following him.
He's very calm-headed. He says the right things at the right time, and sort of ultimately he leads by example. So he's probably the hardest working guy in training and on the pitch.
In an age of rugby monsters, though, Pointon stands out for his size, or lack of it. He only measures 1.70 metres in his socks and weighs in at 78 kilos. The GB captain, though, says size doesn't matter.
Quite a lot of players are getting bigger. However, I like to think that I've still got the speed, I've still got my skills, I've still got a few things that make me unique. So as a scrum half in 15s, I can fit into teams, I believe. There are still players out there, Danny Kerr, like similar sort of size to me. So I hope it would not limit my abilities, and I think in sevens it doesn't matter as much.
This is the seventh edition of the championships. The first took place in Beijing back in 2004. Since then, it's provided an opportunity for students around the world to play on an international stage. Future stars, perhaps. Some, like former Bristol University graduate Tom Mitchell, will likely be playing at the Olympics in Rio next month. Alan Wynne-Jones missed out on the championships but did play student rugby on this ground for Swansea University. Since then, he's played over 100 times for Wales and has captained the British and Irish Lions. He sees the FISU championships as an important part of a player's development.
I think it's an extra stepping stone. I think, particularly in Wales, we have a principality system or principality league, the colleges, and then we have regional rugby. I think it stops anyone slipping through the net, hopefully.
14 nations are represented in Swansea across the men's and women's events. For some, it'll be the highlight of their sporting career. For others, as Wynne-Jones says, it may lead to bigger things. The Welsh international, though, believes every player needs to relish the moment.
It's the yin and yang of it. People get opportunities, some go on further and some stop, but I think they've got to live in the day and appreciate what today is and make the most of the competition. It's a massive added opportunity to be able to play sport and particularly represent your country.
After cruising past the Czech Republic and Italy on the opening day, the British had to move up a gear on day two, up against Australia and Namibia. With only the top two from the group going through to the semi-finals, Great Britain had to win at least one of them. Searing break from Pointon set up a thrilling try. The Australians are always tough to beat, and on this occasion the British missed out. A 19-12 defeat, frustrating for management and for the players. They now had to beat the impressive Namibians or give up on that gold. As per usual, Sam led from the front, a first half try leading to what was ultimately a comfortable and impressive victory. 31-5, the captain impressive, and in the end, the captain impressed.
Really clinical game. Like, skills were up there. I think from our perspective, all round performance, that was probably the best we've had in this tournament. Okay, to shut down a team like that, Namibia, bloody brilliant from us, I thought.
Equally brilliant was their semi-final win over France, but the Australians spoiled the picture once more, a last-minute try stealing the final from the British. A disappointing end, perhaps, to an exciting adventure. Keep an eye on this man, Sam Pointon, though, at the Tokyo Olympics in 2020, perhaps.
In 2016, university sport goes on a journey across the world to share its values and its commitment to athletic and academic excellence. This is a year of FISU World University Championships. More than 8,000 students will compete at the 34 events organized in 25 countries, sharing and chasing their long-held dreams. We are International University Sports Federation. Follow your champions. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.